Right, today let's do a proof of a very useful statement. It says, if we have a vector function that's differentiable and that has constant length, then the vector function and its derivative are orthogonal. So firstly, how can a vector function have constant length? Here, let me give you an example. Let's say this is the origin and this is the length, and this is like the position. And if you want to keep the same length, you're just going to be like this. So in fact, the thing's just moving on a sphere, right? And you keep track of the position. And later on, I'll give you guys an actual example. But let's do the proof first. Let's go ahead and write down PF. Let's assume that we have a vector function that has constant length. So I'm just going to say that let the length of our vector function to be some constant number, let's say C. Okay. Now, how can we show that two factors are orthogonal? One of the best ways is definitely consider the dot product, and hopefully we can show that's equal to zero. Okay. Then we have the vector function and we want to somehow squeeze out the derivative. So what can we do? Well, check this out. Let's go ahead and make an observation. If we have our r of t by itself, let's consider this right here. Whenever we have a factor by itself, what do we get? Let's just say u, and then you just dot itself. This right here will give us the length of the factor u by u square that. Yeah, because remember, imagine this right here is u1 and then u2. And then if you dot itself, u1 and then u2. And the dot product is just this times this, which is u1 squared. And then you add this times that, which is u2 squared, right? And of course, this is the same as if you take the length of it, which is this, and then you square that, right? But we have the length, we call that to be c. So you can say, when we have r of t dot r of t, this is just equal to c squared. Now, we have a product of two, no, dot product of these two factor functions. Let's just go ahead and take the derivative now with respect to t. And here, we are going to use the product rule for the dot product of the factor function. I'm going to keep the first function, which is r of t. And then we multiply by the derivative of this. Ah, this is how we can squeeze out the r prime, right? And then we add the second function, which is still that dot the first one. The derivative of the first one, so it's this. And this right here, of course, the derivative of a constant is zero. So in fact, this right here is the same as 2r of t and then times r prime of t. Cool. Now what? Divide both sides by 2, then you can see that, by the way, this is meant to be dot product in the middle. So this right here, we see r of t dot r prime of t, it does give us 0. The product of r and r prime is equal to 0. Therefore, so I'll just say, so this and the derivative are orthogonal thanks to the dot product. And then we are done. Now, let me show you guys a quick example. So here we have our factor function, 1 plus sine t, and then 1 minus sine t, and then square root of 2 cosine t, and then we have the ijk components, of course. So first, let's verify that this right here does have constant length. Doesn't matter what t is. So if we just consider the magnitude of this, all we have to do is we take the square root and then we square each component, right? So 1 plus sine t and then we square that and then we add 1 minus sine t and then square that and then we add square root of 2 cosine t and then squared. Now let's just go ahead, expand everything. So we have 1 plus 2 times this and that, which is 2 sine t, and then we add this thing squared, and then do the same thing, expand it. We have 1 squared minus 2 times this and that, And then we add this thing squared. Lastly, we have this square, square root of 2 squared is 2, and then cosine squared t. Now have a look. This and that cancel, and then 1 plus 1, of course, is 2. And here, this and that can be combined. So all we have is square root, we have 2, and then plus 2 of the sine squared, and then we have 2 cosine squared. Yeah? And of course, we can factor out the 2 right here, and then this is just sine squared t plus cosine squared t, and then we see our good friend. This is just the one that we have been waiting for. So in fact, this is just 2 plus 2 in the square root, which is square root of 4. Of course, it does have constant length, which is just 2. Now let's go ahead and get its derivative. So r prime of t. The derivative of this is just cosine t. And then the derivative of this is negative cosine t. And then the derivative of cosine is negative sine, so here we will have negative square root of 2 sine t. So, as we can see, if we do r of t dot r prime of t, all we have to do is just take this component times that, and then this times that, and this times that, and then add them up. So I'm going to set them up for you guys. We have 1 plus sine t times cosine t, and this is just a regular multiplication, and then we just continue. 1 minus sine t times negative cosine t, and lastly, square root of 2 cosine t, and then times negative square root of 2 sine t. Okay, let's see if we work this out, we get what? Multiply this in, we get cosine t, and then plus sine t cosine t. Multiply this in, we get negative cosine t plus sine t cosine t. Lastly, this times this is just a 2, and then positive negative, so it's a negative, be careful. 2, and then sine t cosine t. And as you can see, we can cancel stuff up like this. Sine t cosine t, no, just kidding. Cosine t minus cosine t is gone, but we can combine this and that together, which is 2 of them, and guess what? This and that together is 2 of the sine t cosine t, but we have minus 2 of that, so this will be gone as well. So all in all, we do get 0 for the dot product. Therefore, this, right, this factor function is orthogonal to its derivative because this right here has constant length.